everyone. Many of you will have heard of a cycloid. If you don't, I've already made a video on them. I do recommend that you go and watch that one first, but it's by no means necessary. An epicycloid is similar to a cycloid, but instead of following a circle, as we roll along a plane, we roll it over another circle. You'll notice that they make these really cute flowery patterns, where the number of petals is given by the ratio of the inner circle to the outer one. To fully understand how this pattern arises, let's derive the parametric curve describing these epicycloids. The first thing we need to do is agree on some variables that we'll be working with. We're going to call the radius of the static circle r, and the radius of the rolling one little r. We're going to call the angle that the static circle makes with the horizontal theta, and we're going to call this angle alpha. You'll notice the angle between the horizontal and our point is an alternate interior angle of theta, so they must be equal. Now, the first piece of the puzzle is relating alpha and theta. And to do that, we're going to notice that the arc length along this curve has to be equal to the arc length of this one. So S1 equals S2. By the definition of arc length, this is going to be little r times alpha, and that's going to be equal to big R times theta. If we divide on both sides by little r, alpha equals big R theta over little r. Now that we've finished with our setup, to find the final position, we need to split it into two vector functions. The first will take us from the origin to the center of our outer circle, and the second will go from the center of our outer circle to the point of interest. We can add the two sets of functions together to get our final parametric functions. Notice that these two lines have a combined length of big R plus little r, and they make an angle of theta. If you mentally complete a right angle triangle, you'll be able to see that x1 equals big R plus little r times cosine of theta, and y1 equals big R plus little r times sine of theta. To find our second function, we're going to zoom into our outer circle. Notice that this angle is going to be alpha plus theta. Now notice here we have a right angle triangle where the angle is theta plus alpha. x2 equals r cosine theta plus alpha, and y2 equals r sine theta plus alpha. However, since we're going in the opposite direction, we're going to need to throw minuses in front of those. Now that we've already written alpha in terms of theta, we can do a little bit of algebraic gymnastics to get negative r cosine of big R plus little r over little r times theta, and negative r sine of big R plus little r over little r times theta. And for our final function, we just need to add these together. This is a special video for me right now, because the cycloid video I mentioned earlier, my first ever video, is 1 year old today. I've only made 9 videos since then, and my goal for next year is actually to hit 24, which is 2 videos a month. It's going to be hard, but I hope I'm able to manage it. If you liked the video, give it a like and subscribe. If you have any questions or spotted any mistakes, feel free to leave a comment. We've now got a Discord where we can discuss the video and any other math problems you might have. Thanks for watching.